Wetlands in Ontario are at risk. Without any action, they would eventually disappear. But if you live in Burlington or Hamilton, you may be helping restore some of those waterways with your Christmas trees.
Jennifer Bowman and her crew are helping restore Hamilton's marshes with the help of Christmas trees. Most of these trees were in homes in Hamilton and Burlington and were donated to combat an invasive species, the common carp.
They are very prolific. They're not native to this area. They don't have predators once they get to a certain age. And they are ecosystem destroyers, like marsh destroyers. They're feeding. They are uprooting the vegetation and making the water really silty just by their feeding and spawning activities. They're like a rototill going through the marsh, constantly stirring it up.
Since 1999, the Royal Botanical Gardens has been stacking Christmas trees year after year, creating a raised bank that stretches hundreds of meters.
We're trying to recreate the creek channel of Grindstone Creek. This is the lower end of Grindstone Creek, the estuary, if you will, just before it enters Hamilton Harbor. And it's been eliminated from common carp that were introduced in the area a long time ago.
The berm acts as a wall, preventing common carp from entering the sensitive marshlands during spawning. Water flows through the top of the berm, and any dirt or sediment is trapped, reinforcing it.
So everything kind of sinks and gets compressed as all the branches lose their needles and start decomposing.
Every year, the Royal Botanical Gardens goes through over 2,000 Christmas trees, but thanks to record high water levels last year across the province, they need roughly 3,200 trees.
We do the work on the berms and the ice so we can drag the trees over the ice. It's much easier. We can use our gators over the ice and help get them out there. So we didn't have very good ice and we didn't have too many trees to work with. And then over the summer we had extremely high water levels that just about all of our berms were way underwater.
To allow the marshes to recover, the Royal Botanical Gardens have set up these structures along the berm. They allow smaller fish to move freely between the waterways, and any large fish that are already in the marsh are forced to swim out through these angled brushes. The angle prevents larger fish from returning to the marsh, including spawning carp. The common carp, while originally from Asia, is not referred to as Asian carp. They are fast-growing, reaching maturity at 2 years, and can live up to 20 years in the wild.
Common carp are kind of like the forgotten Asian carp. They were the originals that were introduced from Asia to the Great Lakes and as early as the 1800s. People consider them naturalized because they're basically everywhere now in the Great Lakes. There's so many places that they've been introduced and impacted. But they have a real effect on the ecosystem, and they're marsh destroyers, really.
In the mid-90s, there were 70,000 common carp in these waterways. But thanks to extensive conservation work, there were fewer than 1,000. Native vegetation in the marshland is slowly coming back, one Christmas tree at a time.
The Agenda with Steve Bacon is brought to you by the Chartered Professional Accountants of Ontario, helping businesses stay on the right side of change with strategic thinking, insightful decisions, and business leadership. Are you on the right side of change? Ask an Ontario CPA.